guys, welcome to another episode of Momina's Mixplate. Today I have Zainab Abbas in the studio with me. I mean, she does not need any introduction. She has been on the scene of cricket for the last couple of years. She has her own show on Dunya. She has hosted PSL. She's been there for ICC. So, she's popularly known as Virat Kohli's bad luck girl, Zainab Abbas. So, let's welcome her on. Hi, Zainab. Zainab, show shuru ho gaya hai. Phone rakho.
Oh, sorry. I was watching the match.
Yes. Obviously, match bhi saare baat dekhti ho. What's up?
Everything's good. The usual, as you know, I was... mera dhyan abhi bhi jo hai, wo match ke upar hai. Because there was a match going on, but...
ye main inka phone le rahi hu. Aur ye main idhar rakh rahi hu taake... Ye ab thodi der ke liye, your attention towards me.
I am good. I'm just glad that I've had some time off because I'm on the road constantly wherever Pakistan is playing. I'm just with them. So I'm just glad that I'm here and I'm taking my time to get back in shape and work out and just chill out.
Yeah, I know. I asked Zainab to come in a little earlier today and she said, Momina, I can't come here. इतने बजे मेरी जिम होगा मैं उसके बाद आऊंगी वरना मैं नहीं आ रही
यू नो वर्कआउट इज लाइक यू नो हाउ इट इज इट बिकम्स अ वे ऑफ लाइफ एंड देन यू डोंट वांट टू मिस इट फॉर एनीथिंग एंड एज एक्साइटेड एज आई एम टू बी हियर आई कुड नॉट मिस माय वर्कआउट बट नाउ दैट आई एम हियर आई एम रियली लुकिंग फॉरवर्ड टू इट
पीपल जनरली नो अ लॉट अबाउट ज़ैनब शी हैज बिकम लाइक अ सेंसेशन इन पाकिस्तान शी इज टू मी शी इज वेरी स्पेशल बिकॉज शी इज माय चाइल्डहुड फ्रेंड एंड आई हैव नोन हर सिंस वी वर इन क्लास 5 or 6
For the longest time that I can remember from the ugly old days.
Ugly old days when our eyebrows were like this and our mustaches were till here.
Yeah.
But anyways, I have some fun facts about Zainab that you guys might not know that maybe I might be slightly more privy to. Anyway, so she is a huge Shah Rukh Khan fan. For the longest time, until she didn't become like a celebrity and become her face became so recognizable, you could find Zainab at Cosa Nostra on 2nd November, every year cutting a cake and singing happy birthday to Shah Rukh Khan. She once also drove around London during Chennai Express Cape premieres. No, sorry, promotions, right?
Premiere.
To stalk Shah Rukh Khan. And finally, she met him on her birthday and he took a picture with her and wished her happy birthday, which was probably her the best day of her life.
You're making me sound like a stalker.
You are. When it comes to Bollywood celebrities, she is a stalker.
No, only Shah Rukh.
Another really interesting thing that you might not know about Zainab is that she is a dance practice Nazi. She loves to dance and her dance.
I love it. I absolutely love dancing.
I know. Aur itni daant padti hai Zainab se hum sab ko ke girls yaar like कोई एक्सप्रेशन मुंह पे लाओ प्लीज एनर्जी से डांस करो ये किस तरह मरी हुई लाशों की तरह डांस कर रहे हो
देखो यू नीड वन पर्सन लाइक दैट व्हेन एवरीबॉडी इज टू बिजी हैविंग फूड एंड हैविंग ड्रिंक्स यू नीड समबडी हु इज देयर टू यू नो गेट एवरीबॉडी गोइंग
या दैट्स ट्रू यू शुड नेवर विस्पर इन हर लेफ्ट ईयर एवर बहुत दफा हुआ है स्कूल से लेके आज तक दैट आई वांट टू टेल हर समथिंग एंड मैं जाके इसके लेफ्ट ईयर में विस्पर करूंगी और ज़ैनब यू बैठी होगी
I am completely deaf from my left ear, which makes my job even more interesting. We'll talk about that.
And last but not the least, she is such a big foodie that the world comes to a standstill when food comes in front of her. And
yeah,
I think I
become a grumpy little beep. I don't want to say it. Yeah, basically I become a grumpy little beep. When I'm hungry. That notion, hangry, that was made for me.
Yeah, it was definitely, I remember London and when you were living with me.
I used to wake up and the first thing on my mind was, ki nashte mein kya hai, phir lunch mein kya hai,
aur phir snack mein kya hai,
snack mein kya hai,
dinner mein kya hai, dinner ke baad, phir post dinner snack mein kya hai, phir raat ko 2 baje hum kya khayenge. Acha, before I get into the questions that I have, which I have some really fun ones for you, tell me about your left ear and the acting. I'm really interested in knowing this.
Well, you know, so in obviously as a presenter slash anchor, you have a talk back and your producer is constantly talking in your ear in terms of if you have to take a break, if you're doing live shows or whatever the instructions are all coming from the back. And there's so much going on in the back, especially if it's a live broadcast. Peeche commentary ho rahi hoti hai, peeche saath saath director bol raha hota hai, producer bol raha hota hai. And with all of that, you have to be alert and you have a guest that you're trying to listen to. So if the guest is sitting on my left, that is a problem for me. Because it's just like, I've got the earpiece in my right ear and the guest is on my left. So I actually place my earpiece in a way that mujhe usi ear se guest ki awaaz aaye aur mujhe producer ki bhi aaye. And initially I found it very hard. Like when I got into this, I remember one day I came home and I broke down and I told my mom that I can't do this. And she said, why? I was like, because how am I going to be able to listen to the guest and I can't multitask. I can't do it. But you know, with time, as you, it's like you learn on the job.
Yeah.
So you get used to it. You learn how to adjust your earpieces. Yeah. You learn how to... You know, this one is completely farik, but ye to kaam kar raha hai. I'm using it.
I don't know if you know this. So even though I know you really well, but I like for this, I had to do my research.
Yeah.
And while I was doing my research, I think I entered this like black hole of Zainab Abbas on the internet.
Yeah.
So I came across this article that was titled, Zainab Abbas, age, weight, height, body measurements, bra size. And I couldn't read it further. What is the weirdest thing that you've read about yourself online?
What I hear the most is from my social engagement with the audience. So it's like on Twitter, if I'm interacting, jo mujhe tweets aate. And if you have a large following, as soon as you tweet, you get like a million and one replies in like a second. And usme most of the times, the stuff that I get is all about behna, please dupatta le. Behna, please apni ankles cover kare. Sister, you are Muslim. So I get a lot of that stuff. That was weird initially to me because it was like, I'm a sports anchor. Should I wear like main wo shuttlecock burqa pehen ke baith ke apna usna kaam
kar. Acha. So Virat Kohli ki bad luck girl Zainab Abbas. This was coming up. You knew that this would come up. I would talk about this.
I know. I was completely expecting it.
Acha. But what I want to talk about is slightly different move. Ke you recently tweeted about the IPL.
Yeah.
And you got a bit of backlash from...
Yeah.
How do you deal with that?
As a journalist, I know that our people... There's a whole nationalistic element that, you know, you're a Pakistani. But that doesn't mean that you're not allowed to speak on other teams. Be it India or whatever, you know. Cricket is a global sport. And my job as an anchor, presenter, journalist, whatever you want to call it, is to talk about the whole game. It's not just limited to what Pakistan is doing. And the IPL is a massive part of the sport now. You can't ignore it. I mean, jhoot bol rahe hain wo jo kehte hain hum bilkul nahi dekhte. Ho sakta hai kam dekhi ho. Maine bhi utni nahi dekhi thi, but I was following it somewhat.
Yeah.
So, if I saw one of the players play really well and I commented on it and I got a lot of backlash from our Pakistanis that how dare you, you know, the whole jingoistic.
I mean, I guess it got a bit too much in my opinion.
It got a bit too much, but like the way you said I deal with it is that I just ignore it.
Okay. So, since you know how to do makeup yourself and you have been a makeup artist, how do you feel about other people doing your makeup? Do you allow them to do it or do you do it yourself?
I do it myself for all shoots, even when I'm like doing PSL or my work at Dunya. Because I remember the day I started, it was my first day at work at Dunya. And they applied that TV stick on my face with lots and lots of contouring. And I ended up looking like a witch on screen because I've already got sharp features. And if somebody puts contours all over your face, and you know how it is with all the anchors over here,
yeah.
You know, itne itne bade chhatte baal and lots of contouring. So I said to them that, no, you know what, I am going to do my makeup myself. And I do my makeup in 10 minutes, which is a plus because it saves you so much time. So no, I don't let anybody touch my face. Hair I get done, but... I do my makeup myself.
What is the one makeup tip you swear by?
There are lots of products that, you know, I love. But for me, concealer. Because I feel in front of the screen, that's one thing that evens out your skin tone.
Yeah.
So even if you have a concealer and, you know, a bit of blush and the rest of the basic stuff that you use, you're good to go.
So now in your line of work, you have become really good friends with a lot of cricketers.
Yeah.
Who are you closest to?
I share a very good professional working relationship with all of them because it's like aap jab tour pe hote ho to aap inhi logon ke saath hote ho, inhi logon ka aap interview kar rahe hote ho, so when you end up spending so much time with them, I am good friends with Amir from a very long time. And I feel the younger lot now, jo ab jo nayi team aayi hai, the boys are brilliant. Like the younger boys, Shadab, Hassan. So I share a good, relationship with them. Yeah.
So tell me a fun anecdote about Sarfaraz Ahmed that nobody knows or nobody would know.
He's very witty.
Okay.
He's got a great sense of humor, and because he's the captain, and you know he's always in that captain mode where you see him on the field, but even off the field, like I recently did a show with him, and he's hilarious.
If you had to create a fantasy cricket team, and you can choose from anyone internationally, like who would be your first three picks? Which players?
Virat Kohli, because he is the I might not be popular after saying his name because he's an Indian
and you're also his bad luck charm.
Yeah, no, because you see he is the best batsman in the world in all formats, so you have to give credit where due.
Yeah,
so he would definitely be in my team. Rabada, he's a South African fast bowler. He's really exciting to watch. Bowls at like 150 plus. Pakistan mein toh khair, if you ask me who I really watch enjoy watching from the Pakistan team, Amir and Shadab. Amir because you know he's a world class bowler, and Shadab because I think he's the next big exciting thing in Pakistan cricket. You know, he's got it all. He can field, he can bat, he can bowl. So he I really enjoy. And Joss Butler. Okay. Now he is somebody who's he's aggressive, he's got all the shots in the book, and he can completely change the tempo of any game. So he's somebody who I really enjoy watching.
As you were talking earlier, there's a website called hiddenbodyfats.com, and uske andar one of the thing on your marital status was looking for a husband. So,
oh my god,
describe your ideal man.
Yeah, Momina, I don't know if there is that ideal. I mean, we've had this discussion.
I've had this discussion
a lot of times. Where is that ideal man? But if you ask me, like, in terms of what I would be looking for, I think somebody who's stable and mature.
I think stability is most important these days.
Yeah, I guess at least from my perspective, I'm in that phase of my life where I'm independent, working. So for me, I think it would be somebody who's stable and grounded.
Okay guys, now you know. A lot of people have been asking this online. I was like, then I might as well let you guys know what she has on her head.
Yeah.
Anyway, before I get to my next segment, there are a few misconceptions about Zainab. Firstly, guys, she was not born in Karachi. Internet, take it down. She's a Lahori through and through. Like, ki Lahore ki paidawar hai. Karachi se nahi hail karti
hai. Listen, I love Lahore, okay? I'm a true Lahori at heart. And no offense to Karachi. I love Karachi as well, but my roots are in Lahore.
And also, guys, she only has one brother. Iske paanch bhai nahi hai. Iske bahut sare cousins hai. Lekin bhai ek hi hai.
Pata nahi paanch kis tarah likha.
Ye paanch bhai... Every single website has that you have five brothers.
Yeah, I guess wo jo ek hai wo paanch ke.
Wo paanch ke barabar.
Barabar.
Would you rather be in a fist fight with Shahid Afridi or Misbah ul Haq?
Ooh, I think Misbah ul Haq, because I wouldn't want to be paired against a Pathan in any situation whatsoever. So, definitely my chances of succeeding are more against Misbah ul Haq.
Would you rather go to dinner with Shah Rukh Khan or George Clooney?
I love them both. But Shah Rukh Khan.
Of course Shah Rukh Khan. Itna drama mat karo.
Nahi, I needed to show my love for George Clooney as well. So.
Nahi dekh raha. Chances dono nahi dekh rahe.
Bhejungi main usko ye link.
Acha, if you had to watch one film for the rest of your life, would you rather watch Dilwale Dulhaniya Le Jayenge or Kuch Kuch Hota Hai?
DDLJ.
DDLJ.
It's always been, you know, I've seen it like 100 times, even more.
I know that. I'm aware of
she
that.
She knows that.
I am aware.
She would be aware of that. We remember the dialogue by now. Koi baat nahi Sanjita. Bade bade deshon mein aisi choti choti baatein hoti rehti.
Ja Simran ja, ji le apni zindagi.
Pao ji.
Anyways, Zainab, thank you so much for coming in. It was such a pleasure. It is amazing to see other, like your friends and other girls, like women doing so well, and we should always build each other up, and it's an immense moment of pride for me every time I see her on TV. for my parents, for all of us friends. And, you know, I just wish you all the best.
No, but it's been great.
Yeah, thank you so much.
Hi everybody, this is Zainab Abbas and I'm here for Momina's Mixedplate. I've had a great time and I hope that you guys enjoy the show. Please watch it and do subscribe and share.